I want to talk about the latest escalation in Ukraine, the next big war in Africa, and why food prices are probably going to go up worldwide. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel, original, also known as Dimcat. First, the inflation situation. They're calling it a spiral, at least some economists are, simply because you have a situation in Russia and Ukraine where Ukraine's one of the world's breadbaskets. The world, a lot of countries rely a lot on the wheat that comes out of Ukraine. Well, the Russians pulled out of the wheat deal, the grain deal in Ukraine, and because they accuse Ukrainians of using that deal of shipping weapons, using those ships that are supposed to be designed for food shipments and actually using them for weapons and using them as a means to attack the Russian military. So the Russians stepped out of that. They're cutting that off. So a lot of the countries out there won't have access to that grain. Now, you also have a situation in India where they have some weather issues and they're putting in a rice export ban. So rice, wheat, things like this are going to be really important for the world food supply. And we're looking at a significant decline in that. Okay, other things going on right now. Well, let's go to America. 51% of the public say Americans believe that certain college degrees that lead to low-paying jobs shouldn't be funded by the taxpayers. Like, for example, the U.S. government shouldn't provide loans and money for people who go into areas, get college degrees that lead to low-paying jobs. And now this includes gender studies. Let me pull this up. Also includes classics, English, theater. Also, the biggest one was gender studies. After that was art history, which I understand. Then is religious studies. I mean, I don't think you really need a college for this type of stuff, really, though. The biggest issue is that the government pumps so much money into these colleges and these loans that it incentivizes these colleges to provide degrees and degrees that don't necessarily lead to any good paying jobs, but that also incentivizes the universities to raise the cost of tuition. So they have a stronger incentive to continue this. Speaking of other cultural issues, a transgender person, a person born as a man, he identifies as a woman. He's a powerlifter. He broke a world record, a women's world record, by more than 440 pounds. Okay. At a certain point, we have to make a decision as a society. Is it more important to allow half the population, women, to have access to sports than it is to have less than 1% of the population, the transgender individuals, have access to the women's sport? I mean, maybe they can create a separate division for people who are transgender, people who are biological males, or people born as males who identify as women. Maybe they can compete against one another, but having them compete against women, it's ridiculous, especially in something like weightlifting, powerlifting. It just seems absurd to me. Zelensky, there's a escalation, a historic deal where now the Netherlands, they're going to send, 42 F-16 fighter jets to Ukraine, and Denmark supposedly is going to send 19. Now, it hasn't been confirmed yet, but we're talking over 60 F-16s. This obviously is an escalation. The Russians have air superiority. They're trying to remedy that situation by helping the Ukrainians by giving them the F-16s. I don't see that changing what ultimately happens here. The Russians have an excellent air defense, but we shall see. Look, the fact of the matter is, people, I know you guys are sick of hearing about Ukraine, but it's going to affect everybody. It's going to affect the food prices. It's going to affect what you see at the grocery store. It's going to affect geopolitics, especially if you're in Europe. Germany, their economy is stagnant right now. They're saying because of their manufacturing. Well, of course, Germany, they relied on cheap Russian gas. So without that cheap Russian gas, it's really expensive for them to run a lot of those manufacturing plants. So that's cutting into their bottom line. That's affecting the ability to create products with a really good margin, because they got to pay for more expensive energy. I mean, that problem isn't going to go away. They had two quarters where they had negative growth, so they were in a recession, and it looks like they're looking at stagnation right now. Okay, until they solve the energy problem, they're not going to resolve the core problem. Bankruptcies in the EU hit their highest since 2015, according to Eurostat. Not a big surprise, okay? So this is a situation where the people at the very top of government in Europe didn't look out for the best interest of the people below them. And the same thing happened in Hawaii. There's a media blackout. The governor of Hawaii came out and said that you shouldn't listen to social media influencers and all this other stuff. There's always this concern about, you know, conspiracy theories and all this other stuff, but then, you know, they also want to limit the information people can get. I mean, look, do your if you didn't limit the amount of water that certain companies can get during this crisis, if you didn't make certain, if certain people within the government didn't make decisions, people wouldn't be questioning them. They act like, oh, it's a crime. It's more immoral to question the authority figures. It's not. Not at all, okay? Okay, I'm actually more suspicious when someone says, you shouldn't question me. Anyway, Ford. Ford CEO admits reality check when he drove the F-150, the electric F-150 truck on a road trip. Well, this electric vehicle craze, it's not even a craze. It doesn't make any sense because even if you do, one, there's no infrastructure in place. I think Tesla and Ford, they worked out a deal where they can actually use the same chargers. But this guy ran into an issue where it took him, 40 minutes just to charge the battery up to 40%. That's not practical for as an everyday drive, everyday vehicle. That's completely impractical. This doesn't make any sense. I wonder why Tesla went along with this deal with Ford. Probably because they want to make it more mainstream. That's going to ultimately help their products. They figure, well, if they work with Ford, they can use their stations if they do develop some, and it'll help ultimately help their product as well. And since they sell a superior product, at least when it comes to electric vehicles, maybe they'll have the advantage. It doesn't make any sense because even if you are plugging into the grid, where do you get the energy from? You know, where do you get the energy from? You can say, oh, it's clean energy. We're not using natural gas. We're not using combustible engines or anything like that. Well, okay, where are you getting the energy on the power grid? Coal plants? I mean, that sort of defeats the purpose of the whole green revolution talk. Speaking of the grid, there's more support for nuclear power than ever before. A lot of Americans were apprehensive about nuclear power because of Fukushima and a lot of stuff that happened. Well, that type of crisis. But now a majority of Americans, 57%, say they favor more nuclear power plants to generate electricity for the country. Now, solar is at 82% and wind is at 75%. The problem is you can't actually run cities off of those energy sources. It doesn't make any sense at this point. So nuclear fission, yes, that's what we have. Nuclear fusion will be even better. That will be gaining energy from combining two atoms, okay? So you won't have to deal with the nuclear waste or anything like that. So that would be great, but we're not at that point. Realistically, nuclear power is going to have to be a part of our strategy moving forward. There's all this talk about the green this, green that. Hey, you guys share your thoughts on where we're going as far as this. I already told you what I thought. The big war, the next war is coming up. It's basically Niger. So you have Western powers dumping money into the African countries, African governments to get them to do their bidding. Okay, so there was a coup in that country where they removed the leadership and now they're being supported by the Russians. The Wagner groups are getting involved. So now you're gonna see France put more resources into that country because that country is a big exporter of uranium. And since France has a ton of nuclear power plants, it's gonna be in their best interest to protect their investment. That's how I see the situation. So we're gonna be looking at probably another big conflict. It won't just stop with Ukraine. All right, guys, share your thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Question of the day, do you think the next front in this big war, possibly World War III, is going to be in Africa?